फ्रेंड्स वेलकम बैक टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल टेक विद फ्रेंड्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू व्हाट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू फिजिकल वर्ड पार्ट नंबर 2 इन पार्ट नंबर 1 वी हैड डन व्हाट टू थिंग्स वी हैड डन दैट व्हाट इज फिजिक्स ओके व्हाट इज फिजिक्स एंड यूनिफिकेशन एंड Reductionism. These two things we had done. Okay. Yes. Now today we in part number 2. We are going to do what scope and excitements. Scope and excitements. And second part we are going to do fundamental forces in nature. And there are too many forces. We will talk today about gravitational force. Okay, yes. So this is what our today's schedule. So we are going to kill it. Okay, yes. So let's start, but before if you're new on my channel, please get it subscribed and press the bell icon because I publish such interesting videos regularly on this YouTube channel. So let's get started after about type of intro. Now on to today's first topic. So today's first topic is about scope and excitement. In scope and excitement there are two parts. Okay, there are two parts, macroscopic and microscopic. Okay, macro means big, micro means small. Okay, so big scope and small scope, from the meaning at what it is seem to be happen. Okay, so in macroscopic what happens and in microscopic what happens, we are going to study that thing. Okay, it means from this heading we can conclude what we are going to read in class 11th physics and class 12th physics. Okay, yes, what we are going to deal with physics in these 2 years, 11th and 12th. Okay, yes. Now macroscopic is what? It includes phenomenon at the laboratory, the phenomenon which happens at the laboratory, that included in macroscopic. Okay, terrestrial and astronomical scale, getting this? It means the phenomenon which happen at laboratory, terrestrial and astronomical scale are included in macroscopic scope. Okay, yes. It is studied in classical physics. Okay, means macroscopic means what? Classical physics. Okay, classical macroscopic scope comes in macroscopic scope comes under classical physics. Okay, yes. Now which include what? Classical in physics included mechanics, thermodynamics, optics and electrodynamics. In which mechanics, thermodynamics and optics you are going to read in class 11th, and electrodynamics you are going to read in class 12th. Okay, yes. So this is what macroscopic. Okay, what macroscopic. Now so simple heading this was. Now going toward microscopic. So this domain includes molecular, nuclear and atomic phenomena. The phenomenon which included molecular, nuclear and atomic phenomena, the things happen in molecular level and nuclear level and the atomic level. Okay, so it is studied in quantum physics. Now microscopic scope comes under quantum physics. Okay, quantum physics. Okay, yes. माइक्रोस्कोपिक स्कोप क्लासिकल फिजिक्स, माइक्रोस्कोपिक स्कोप क्वांटम फिजिक्स. सो दिस इज सो इजी हेडिंग एंड वी हैड किल्ड इट. आई हैड ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर इन एनी ऑफ द कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स जस्ट लाइक जेई नीट नो क्वेश्चंस आर गोइंग टू बी कम. दिस इज ओनली फॉर इंफॉर्मेशन फॉर व्हाट आर यू गोइंग टू स्टडी इन क्लास 11th एंड 12th. ओके सो दैट्स डन. Now moving toward the today's second topic. Today's second topic is what? Fundamental forces in nature, and we are going to study in that what? Gravitational force. What? Gravitational force. Gravitational force we are going to study in that. Okay, so let's move there towards that also. So let's go there. Now going to today's second topic. So today's second topic is about fundamental forces in nature. So there are so many forces we will study about them, all of them. But first force we are going to discuss about gravitational force. Okay, gravitational force. There are I have 5 points on which we are going to discuss about gravitational force. Okay, yes. So it is so important. Points, you can take a screenshot of them also. My tripod is going loose, so I am going to renew it. Sorry for the poor quality. Okay, yes. So gravitational force, the first of the point is what? It is the weakest force founded in nature. Means gravitational force is the weakest force. It means weak of all force. सबसे ज़्यादा weak यही है, weakest of them all. There are so many force founded in nature, among them this is the weakest force. Okay, getting this? I think you are getting my point. Okay, yes. So what? It is the weakest force founded in nature. Second is what? It is the force between any two objects by virtue of their masses. It's like you have a football and this is your ground. So we have two objects, one a football and one is the ground. Each of them have mass. Suppose it has mass 1 and it has mass 2. Now it will work on the virtue of their masses. Okay, yes. So it is the force between any two objects by the virtue of their masses. Okay, getting this? Yes, I think you can. It is always active in nature. This point we all know that it is always active in nature. It's like suppose that it have a timing that from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. it is active only. Okay, so suppose it has a timing of 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. it is only active in 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. okay, so what about the other things? If you between this time, if you throw a ball upward, it will come down. But what happen will when you will throw that ball at 8 a.m. it will hang in the air, okay, or it will go wherever it anywhere. Okay, so suppose अगर मान लीजिए इतना ही टाइमिंग हो ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एक्टिव होने का, तब इस पर बॉल फेंकते हैं तो वो बॉल हवा में लटके रहेगी. जैसे ही 9 बजेगा तब ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स जब एक्टिव होगा तब वो बॉल नीचे गिरेगी. सो दैट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल. ओके, सो इट इज़ ऑलवेज एक्टिव इन नेचर. ओके, इट इज़ ऑलवेज एक्टिव इन नेचर. गेटिंग दिस? यस, आई थिंक. सो इट इज़ अ यूनिवर्सल फोर्स. यस, इट इज़ अ यूनिवर्सल फोर्स. गेटिंग दिस? Universal force means it works on all objects. It works on all things. Okay, as human, table, everything. It works on everything. Okay, so it is a universal force. Now the last point is what? It is appreciable only when at least one of the two objects have a large mass. Means it is seen only when there are two objects. Okay, a ball and a ground. No, leave this. Think a paper is in air and this is the ground. The mass of paper is negligible. Okay, the mass of the paper is negligible. But the mass of ground is so much, na? So gravitational force active and this will become going down into the ground. Okay, yes, so it is only seen when the two of the bodies have a large mass. When one of the two of the bodies have a large mass. Getting this? I think you should learn. Let's revise all those terms. It is the weakest force hai. ठीक है, और वो दो ऑब्जेक्ट्स के बीच में लगता है इसके मासेस के अकॉर्डिंग, उसके मासेस के अकॉर्डिंग वो दो ऑब्जेक्ट्स के बीच में लगता है. ठीक है, और इट इज़ ऑलवेज एक्टिव इन नेचर. वो नेचर में ऑलवेज एक्टिव रहता है. जस्ट लाइक एग्जांपल दिस इज़ द मार्कर एंड नाउ इस टाइम जो है वो ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स एक्टिव है. तो अगर मैं इसे छोड़ूंगा तो ये ग्राउंड की तरफ गिरने लगेगा, जस्ट लाइक दिस. ओके, ये ग्राउंड की तरफ गिरेगा. मीन्स इट इज ऑलवेज एक्टिव इन नेचर एवरी टाइम, नॉट इन अ सिंगल मिनट, इट इज नॉट इवन अ सिंगल मिनट इट इज डी एक्टिव. ओके, सो इट इज एक्टिव इन एक्टिव ऑलवेज इन द नेचर. ओके, सो इट इज अ यूनिवर्सल फोर्स ऑल्सो एंड इट इज अप्रिसिएबल. वो यूनिवर्सल फोर्स भी है, वो तभी देखा जा सकता है जबकि हमारे पास दो बॉडीज हो और दो बॉडीज में किसी एक बॉडी का मास ज़्यादा हो. ठीक है, यस, नॉट लाइक दिस. ऐसा ना हो कि दोनों जो बॉडी हो इसी पेपर की तरह निगलिजिबल मास वाले हो. ठीक है, निगलिजिबल मास वाले नहीं होने चाहिए. ठीक है, सो ओके, दैट्स डन फॉर टुडे. फिल अप दिस वीडियो, लाइक दिस वीडियो, कमेंट ऑन दिस वीडियो एंड शेयर दिस वीडियो अमंग ऑल यू नो. सो दैट्स डन फॉर टुडे. इफ यू न्यू ऑन माय चैनल प्लीज गेट इट सब्सक्राइब्ड एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन. सो बिकॉज आई पब्लिश सच इंटरेस्टिंग वीडियोज ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल, सो लेट्स एंड टुडेज वीडियो हियर. गो एंड लिव योर लाइफ.